When I say ionising radiation, what happens? Are you scared? Do you think of death? It is, after all, the radiation that kills. But don't be worried when you get your next x-ray, because a small dose does little harm. However, when the first man-made ionising radiation was produced in 1895, the effects of x-rays were unknown. In fact, x-rays were used in such high doses for extended periods of time, patients experienced hair loss, burns, lesions, and other damage from treatments. It was only 9 years later that the first person died from cancer caused by x-rays. Although, this isn't surprising when considering x-rays were named X because of their unknown properties, so they were a bit of a red flag from the beginning, right? Of course, scientists did try to research x-rays for the next couple of decades to determine their effects. However, no studies had conclusively determined the properties of x-rays or their impacts until Hermann Joseph Muller in 1927, who informed the world of its deadly consequences. Muller conducted experiments where he x-rayed sperm and eggs of Drosophila melanogaster, the fruit fly, and determined that all offspring had mutations in their genes. In fact, they had 15,000 times the mutation rate compared to that of the untreated germ cells. These mostly recessive mutations were observed in autosomal chromosomes. However, they were more common in the X chromosome, indicating that many mutated genes were sex-linked. This allowed Muller to follow the mutations through generations, particularly in males who would display the phenotype. These mutations were observed in several subsequent generations, showing that reverse mutations were not occurring to fix the mutations previously caused by x-rays. The irradiated germ cells consisted of mainly homozygous recessive lethals that eventually resulted in death, and dominant lethals which never developed to maturity. Only some mutations were non-lethals which caused phenotypic abnormalities, with common mutations including the X-linked white eye and miniature wing, which continued in following generations. Additionally, a large proportion of the male population had sterility caused by heterozygosity. Muller revolutionized genetics with the discovery of point mutations, where singular nucleotides can be substituted, inverted, deleted, or inserted into a gene, with frameshift mutations, by insertion or deletion, being the most dangerous because they can result in nonsense mutations with early stop codons. And what causes point mutations? You guessed it! Ionising radiation, of course. The mutations produced have the potential to be repaired. However, replication of misrepaired DNA results in the mutation being fixed into the genome, which can have detrimental effects. Ionising radiation also causes double-stranded DNA breaks, resulting in fractional effects where portions of chromosomes consisting of thousands of nucleotides undergo fragmentations, inversions, duplications, and translocations, creating major chromosomal rearrangements. These mutations are the most lethal because they can trigger cell death or mutate tumour suppressor genes and oncogenes, disrupting the cell cycle to cause uncontrolled cell growth, resulting in cancer. Muller's work was highly debated as the paper wasn't peer-reviewed and didn't provide data or methods. However, despite this, the results were eventually provided and Muller was awarded the Nobel Prize in Physiology 2 decades later for the discovery that mutations can be induced by X-rays. Further research showed that ionising radiation, which includes alpha and beta particles, gamma rays, and X-rays, can cause unpairing of electrons on atoms, creating highly reactive particles. Gamma and X-rays are the highest energy and most dangerous because they can enter the skin barrier and directly hit DNA, causing single or double-stranded DNA breaks, or alternatively create highly unstable hydroxyl radicals by removing electrons from water in cells so that the molecule has unpaired electrons. This free radical attacks nucleotides and DNA, causing mutations. Ironically, ionising radiation is now used to fight cancer by targeting rapidly multiplying cells for death. Radiation therapy is used by more than half of all cancer patients to induce DNA damage, which results in apoptosis of cancerous cells, stopping tumour growth. This therapy is effective because cells with high proliferation rates are more susceptible to the DNA damage response in the cell cycle than regular cells. However, cells can become resistant to radiation and continue to proliferate and create tumours that cannot be targeted by radiotherapy. Clearly, ionising radiation is a carcinogenic mutagen, particularly if you're exposed to high quantities for extended periods of time. However, it can be a beneficial cancer treatment in small amounts. So, ionising radiation can both damage DNA and help combat cancer, but it's best not to get too many x-rays because the effects are directly proportional to dose.